dealing with it rather than dealing with it. And then men say, well, if I'm going to grieve, what does that mean? I have to go like girls when we have a group crying session or these other things? And I'm not saying you can't have that. You can have anything you want. What I'm saying is that the reason it's difficult for men to grieve is because we don't even know what it looks like. How do men grieve? I was asked that question when I was going through something of that nature, and I didn't have an answer. And in fact, was one of my professors, she said to me, she says, come to think of it, I don't know how men grieve. Maybe you were supposed to go through this grieving situation and write a chapter about it. Guess what? That's what I did. And it took me a long time to understand how men grieve and how to grieve, because we're not supposed to grieve. So we talk about that. We can use these very techniques in business. How do you grieve the loss of employees? How do you grieve the loss of business and the fear? Okay, we all have experienced that. It's nothing wrong with grieving, and it doesn't have to look like, you know, hysterics. It can just look like being sad and talking about it. So one of the things that are critically important is to understand the need for communication. That's what's the most important thing I can offer you today. Communicate what you're feeling. When you have communication, honesty, integrity, openness, vulnerability, and love. That's it. And those are the things that can be taught and should be taught and worked on within the boardroom, as where every other place. Most people hear that and they go, well, that's for relationships. I'll talk about that with my wife. No, you talk about that with your coworkers. You talk about that with your friends. You talk about it with everybody. Because what happens is the holding in of emotions actually makes it like a pressure cooker. And you wind up just building more and more pressure inside. And you're not allowed to release that. So instead of pressure cooking, you just open the lid and you just let it out. And you don't put it in a pressure cooker. And it dissipates, and you'll find that this big emotion is very small. It's only big because you put so much energy into repressing it and keeping it back. And yes, I am. So for example, you know the typical situation, you know, that right now the man comes home and, you know, how's your day, honey? And of course, nowadays it's usually difficult. Fine. And he goes off and watches TV, works on his computer, whatever, has quiet dinner. And of course, you know, that makes his wife feel totally connected, right? Well, not really. And so she goes, and what does she do? Because she doesn't know what's going on. Or she may see sort of, but it's like, does she feel like the relationship's in jeopardy? It's affecting her? Of course she does. She'll go, what's going on here? I don't know. Is it me? Is it the work? Is it both? What's happening here? I don't know how to reach this, and it's going to affect her and their relationship. When all he has to do is saying, you know, I felt terrible today. I felt helpless. I don't know how to change this. You know, the world has come apart, and I don't know what to do about it. And so that scares me. You're thinking, well, I have to protect the little woman, right? Like she can't handle that. And there may be the opposite situation, or whatever the situation may wind up being. And, you know, bottom line is you have to be able to communicate what you're feeling. Women do this, come home to their men. We all, business women, often don't communicate much more about those things either, because they wind up becoming more masculinized and shut those parts down. Hopefully not as much as men do. And my whole purpose is first working with the men right now. My second book actually is obviously for women. But the thing is, you go home, you communicate it. You say, hey, I felt terrible today. And what she's going to go is, oh, okay, I understand. And then she knows it's one, not about her or the relationship, and that she could be there and be supporting of you. And what happens is when you don't do that, you lose the most important thing you have, your support system, your partner. And the same can be for a woman coming home to a man, or both coming home. You know, one of the most important things is the community. The community, the humanness, the family, which I look at as not just being wife, children. I'm talking about my friends, my coworkers. Every person is part of my family on this planet to one degree or another. And we wind up going, you know, either we're an island, or maybe you include your family. But then you're alone within that. And what happens is that really harms you. So you get the opportunity to change that by talking about it. I have an example of, I had a situation a couple of years back. I was seeing someone, and I'm divorced, and it wasn't working, clear. And I said, okay, done. And I went to my Starbucks that I usually go to, and my buddies were all there, and they're all looking at me and going, what's the matter? And I said, Well, you know, I broke up with so-and-so. And they said, oh, you really liked her? I said, well, I liked her, but I could see this wasn't the right thing. So they said, so what are you sad about? I said, well, here I am, I'm 55, and I'm afraid I'm going to be alone for the rest of my life. And they all looked at me, you know, jaws hit the floor. You know, this is not Starbucks conversation, right? And next thing I know, for a half hour, every one of them were talking about the exact same thing and how they felt the same thing and could never say it. Because how do you share that? But you share it. You talk about it. You open your heart and say, hey, this is it. I didn't have to say much, and I walked away feeling much better simply because I wasn't alone with it. Often, you feel alone with those feelings, and you think, oh, nobody's going to understand that. And then you finally tell somebody, and they go, well, I feel the same way. I have the same fears, the same insecurities, the same thing as you do. We're all human. And that's how we come together as family and with a connection that's more important than any amount of money, than anything else. And it is the thing that hopefully this world will change into, because that's the only way we're going to save it. Unless we come together, we're going to continue to self-destruct and basically become parasite. You know how when bodies die, what happens? The bacteria eats it away until it's nothing. Well, we've been doing that for long enough. We're on our knees now, and so we have a choice. We can rebuild it or we can let it go. And I'm going to tell you right now that the key, the secret, is coming together as community and as family. And that doesn't mean stopping being in business, doing things like that. It means just recognizing and taking in every other human soul that you work with and considering every other human soul. And that's the premise behind Men, the Gods of Love. And the concept for the second book will be the opposite, where men are taught to disconnect from their emotions. Women are taught to disconnect from their minds. Oh, honey, don't trouble your little self. I'll handle it. And that says that you're not smart enough. And of course, that's nonsense. Women are just as smart. So it's about changing that. Now, you know, some of the little things, and let me just verify, how are we on time? Are we...
About time to wrap it up.
About time to wrap it up? Yeah. Okay. So I will do that. I will wrap it up now. I can go on for another, I don't know, 3 weeks. So probably you all want to get out of here, so I'm going to let you go. But are there any questions? Anybody have any questions or anything they'd like to ask? Great. Well, so don't forget to put your card in that little fishbowl. And if you'd like a copy signed by me of my book, please come see me, and I'll be happy to sign one for you. Thank you.